Welcome to episode 200 of the Clarity Compressed podcast. My name is Paul J. Daly, and today we're going to talk about taking a minute to soak it in.
We're making our way through the fog of life, and clarity is understanding where we are on the map. You are here.
Let the good times roll.
This is Clarity Compressed.
Okay, as you can see, I'm not in my office. I am in beautiful Miami Beach at the NAMED conference. I got to show you the rig. I had to fix up to get my camera set. My wife, Sara, helped me do it. But I just got done receiving an award, the Diversity Advocacy Award from NAMED. And let me just say, I don't take enough time to soak things in. And my wife, Sara, helped me remember that today. And so for episode 200, I thought it would be good to talk about taking a minute to soak in an accomplishment. 200 episodes every week. Every week for the last 200 weeks, I have figured out a way to make this happen. And the only reason I figure out a way to make this happen is because I know that you, listener, viewer, have been with me for a lot of this journey. And that for some reason or another, the interaction that we have through the podcast, through the content, through business, through real life, has somehow given you a little bit more clarity, a little bit more perspective. But I guarantee you 1,000% that I have been the beneficiary of this podcast far more than anyone else, because the discipline of doing this, the discipline of trying to serve on a regular basis and trying to be consistent with doing something, has opened more doors in my life and more doors in my heart and more relationships than I could have ever imagined. And so the NAMED Diversity Advocacy Award is an award that NAMED gives out every year to someone who has served their community, served the NAMED community. It's the National Association of Minority Auto Dealers, has served their community in trying to help them in their pursuits to raise awareness, to move the ball forward, to get more inclusion in the automotive industry. I didn't even realize how big a deal it was until I got here, which even made it more of an honor. And the NAMED community has been so warm and welcoming. Like, I feel like I'm part of the family now. It's been an amazing event. Damon Lester, one of our troublemakers, has been an amazing host. He brought in Lil Jon for the after party last night, which was a whole lot of fun. My wife and I got to spend the evening dancing a little bit. And when you have four kids and a foster child, like, you don't get to spend some time dancing. So that was a good thing. But the main topic today, and what I really wanted to talk about, is taking a moment to appreciate the wins. And, you know, my wife says, she helps me do that, because I usually get so busy that I push past the wins and I don't celebrate them. And that not only has a negative effect, I think, on me, but also has a negative effect on my family, on my team. I know some of you don't struggle with this. I struggle. Maybe you celebrate the wins too long. So whatever it is, today we're going to talk about either celebrating the wins too much or not enough. The reason that I think it's good, even introspection, even in the last half an hour on celebrating the wins, is because isn't that why we work so hard? The wins? Isn't that why we push? Isn't that why we keep marching in the direction that we're marching? So that we will experience the good things. We will experience the wins. Life and business is, as Simon Sinek would say, an infinite game, which means it's not like a football game where there's a clock and a timer and rules and score and all of that. That's a football game. You can easily see who won and lost. But in life and business, it's an infinite game, meaning the rules constantly change. You're introduced with new variables that you didn't have to deal with before. And so that you can never really say you've won, but what you can say is, I'm going in a good direction, or the trajectory that I'm on is one that I like, is one that I think is beneficial, is one that is in line with the person I think I want to be and the person I think I'm supposed to be and was made to be. And so celebrating the wins gives us the indicators that we're doing the right things. And when you don't stop, and when I don't stop to think about those and just lump them all into saying, like, okay, I'm happy with the way things are going, so we're going to keep going, what that does is rob me and rob the people around me and close to me of the depth of fulfillment that comes from doing a good thing. And when you do a good thing, really that's indicated by a win a lot of the times. Sometimes you see them fast, and sometimes they're small wins. Sometimes there are big wins, and celebrating the small wins and the big wins are essential to reminding us that we're going in a good direction. On the flip side of that, there are some people that celebrate wins that aren't really wins, right? You know, you get really excited and you high five. Now, there are good things about being positive. There are good things about being optimistic, right? I definitely adopt optimism, right? I don't want to be delusional, delirious, but I definitely want to be optimistic. But there are some people that celebrate small wins or make a big deal over something that shouldn't be a big deal. And that, on the flip side, convinces you that you are doing the things that are moving you in the right direction, when in all of reality, maybe you're not. Maybe it's just hype. Maybe it's just energy that it's expended that lies to you and tricks you into thinking that you're doing a good job, when really there's still a lot of work to be done. I think it's a good moment to get some perspective on that. Ask yourself, like, do I celebrate too many wins? Like, am I over-celebrating or am I under-celebrating? And I have an inkling to think that a lot of the people that watch and listen to this podcast are very driven, are very motivated, they're always going somewhere, and are probably a lot more likely to not celebrate the wins. Before the two-year mark, which is coming up, because, you know, 1 year podcast, so episode 208 would be a two-year celebration. We're going to celebrate that one, too. If you're going to stand there, you have to come in. Thank you. I get to share this. I've been here for not only 36 hours, and now we have to leave, which is really tough when you're in the middle of a winter in New York, because it's like 80 degrees here and sunny. Not saying that I could deal with this all year, because I couldn't. I like the cold weather, but it's a nice moment. I'm glad I got to share it with you. Thank you so much for paying attention and listening to this podcast. For me, that's the biggest win, that there are other people that are on the journey. I like and get fulfillment and energy out of doing things together. So today, find a win that is worth celebrating and celebrate it. It might be a text message. It might be going out to dinner. It might be planning a vacation. I don't know. Find a win, a real legitimate win that means something, that indicates to you and the people around you that you're moving in the right direction, and celebrate it today. Until next week, keep celebrating the wins. Keep pursuing that clarity. I'll see you soon.